All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we are departing from Sao Tome, which is where we landed last flight. I believe that's a Portuguese colony here in Africa, off the southern coast of Liberia. Anyways, today we are departing runway 11. Not a direct out flight. Have about a 3 nautical mile an hour headwind, so light winds. About 5 miles visibility on the outbound departure today. They're having us loop around the runway once before we exit out of the area. It's kind of a strange departure pattern. We'll be shooting for a cruise altitude of 26,000 feet today. And we shouldn't have a whole lot of winds or anything. Looks like it's pretty clean air. Total flight time should be 2 hours and 16 minutes. And we're flying to the Republic of Congo to Kinshasa. Airport designator is FZAA Foxtrot Alpha Alpha. We'll be inbound on EPEL G1P06 arrival pattern. And we'll be flying a radio navigation approach for landing on runway 06. And it looks like we have light headwinds about 6 miles an hour on the inbound. So kick back, relax, and we should be off the ground here in just a few minutes. Looks clear out to 200 nautical miles, so should be pretty clear. Altitude of I think it's 16,000 feet. I'm not sure where they're going to have us descend to on the ground, so we'll just dial in 4,000 for the time being. Gassed up, fueled up. We should be ready for departure here in just a second. Alright. You say we get out of here. Departing. Engines cooling up. Brakes released. Airspeed alive. We're gonna hold nose down. We're full of fuel on the outbound here. Crossing minimums. Nose up. Running something right around medium with some things at high and ultra, but overall, like, medium settings across the board. And installed everything this morning, and we're running on the very high end, not quite ultra, but just a notch under that. Everything appears to be fine. There's some things that are different, like these numbers appear to be blurry on the altimeter, and I'm not sure if that's from the video patch and update, or I'm guessing it is. So yeah, there's some things that are a little different that I'm not quite sure yet. Maybe we'll give it a shot, see how it pans out. And it might be the greatest thing since sliced bread, or say kick back, relax, and enjoy the climb up. Just crossed over flight level 160 on our way to 210. Should be there in about 2 minutes and 20 seconds. Climbing up at 2,000 feet per minute, and should be there pretty quick. Should just run up just a little bit. 10 minutes remain to turn. And near up is this nav point right here. Had some updates. Also to the simulator, there's some different icons that you displayed on the navigation display, which is kind of nice. You can see airports, you can ground, nav aids. So those are nice to see on the map. I'm not sure about game improvements and things like that, but so far I like what I see. I think this is intentional, this blur here, just to make it look like we're vibrating slightly like it would be in real life. So yeah, everything appears to be really smooth. Nothing chunky is going on. Nothing really unexpected is going on. So I think that is a good thing. Thank you. flight time today so far. It's been about 28 minutes. So 47 minutes. This is a little bit longer than I thought. I looked at the map. So we have 47 minutes until our next nav point. And I believe that one's actually over land. So, yeah, we should have roughly 20, maybe even 10 minutes until landfall. And then from this point on the coast, Fuk, to race off is probably 35 minutes or so. And then from race off to Belugu, that'll be our last long leg, and that's probably been about 45 minutes as well. So it looks like we have 90 minutes right there, and our initial approach is probably going to be about another 20 minutes as well. So that's 90, 100, 110, so 1 hour and 50 minutes, plus the half hour we've already been here. That's roughly 2 hours, 20 minutes, so fairly close to the flight plan, not too far. Flight plan, I think, was calling for 2 hours and 15 minutes, roughly 2 hours and 16 minutes, so we're not too far from that. Well, not a mile ahead, but it's going to slow us down a touch, but nothing too dramatic. And I keep pushing the throttles up just a little bit incrementally just to get us close to the sound barrier marker, half as good sound anyways. See the coast up ahead, under the clouds. Peninsula right here. Almost directly right on our nose, so sometimes when the headwind comes off the wing, the aircraft gets bounced around, but right now it was really smooth cutting through this, so I figured it would be countering a little bit more turbulence than what we have. This is super smooth. So smoke them if you got them. So I'm just wondering if my microphone was off. So I'm not sure if the first half hour I was jabbering away into the microphone was actually coming through. So if everything's been quiet up to now, I'm sorry about that. So, since I don't know if the microphone was on or off, I'll just recapitulate the flight plan today. We departed from Sao Tome, which is off the coast of Liberia, I believe, about 100 nautical miles. Foxtrot Papa Sierra Tango FPST is the airport designator. And we departed runway 11 on a straight-out departure. Really light headwind of 3 nautical miles an hour. Had a little bit of low-lying clouds visibility with about 5 miles. We shot for a cruising altitude of 26,000 feet, which we're at right now. We're on our way to Kinshasa, which is the Republic of Congo, and we'll be arriving on a BELP-1B06 arrival pattern, Bravo Echo Lima Golf 1 Bravo. And today we're coming in to land on runway 06 for a radio navigation approach on that. So we should have, with RNAV, information directing us left, right, but not up, down, so no worries on that. Light winds, the map was showing six knots at landing. That was what's going on right now. Hopefully that won't change too much when we get there, so should be smooth all the way to the Congo. So the flight plan was calling for 2 hours and 16 minutes, and looks like we're gonna hold pretty close to that. So yep, I pushed our throttle all the way to max. I was trying to get to half the speed of the sound barrier, but I don't think we're gonna quite make it, so I'm just gonna leave everything where it's at for right now. Probably pull the throttle back just a skosh. See land down below. There's a tip of the peninsula we'll be flying over here in a little bit. You can see it right here in the nav map. It's this little tip right here. Definitely cloudy up ahead. Can see some light clouds on radar. I'll just leave that up for the time being. Don't want any surprises. I didn't look at actual weather, so I'm not sure what the weather will be like in the area, but the maps didn't look too bad when we planned the flight today, so I don't think we're close enough to get meteorological information and data. We'll just keep that up for the time being. Well, I won't get it. Those are kind of ugly. Look at. The actual time in the area is a little after 3 p.m. 5 hours ahead of time zone where I live. So we're using real time, real weather. What we see here weather-wise should be fairly close to what we'd see if we were actually in the area flying around. So wanted everything to be as close to real world as possible, so we just never know, flight to flight, what we're running into. Let's look at our flight plan on the computer here. Our first step down is to 10,000 feet. So let's go ahead and dial in 10,000 in preparation for that. So we're not caught off guard. They might call in for a higher or lower altitude, and that's fine. We can just use that as a target for when we first start to descend, and we'll just make any changes at that point to it. Everything looks good here for fuel. Everything is in the green. We have more than enough gas. Alternator looks good, but we got enough current to power everything. Oil pressure looks good. Prop torque and RPMs look good. And our turbine output looks good, where nothing is overheating or in the red. We do have some weather forming off the nose, directly off of the nose to the east by southeast. You can see these green dots on the radar. And these are the densest parts of the clouds, but not the entire clouds. The entire clouds would be taking up the entire horizon if you look off the nose here in a second. So there's way more clouds than what radar shows, but radar is just looking at moisture, and there's very little of that. So as cloudy as it looks up there, it's really not as menacing as it we think it is. However, there could be winds in it, so we're not really sure what to expect for that. Anyways, most of this these clouds were above. I think this band here might be above us, but all these clouds right here should be below us. See here how everything turns out as we push forward. We have roughly 34 minutes until Raso, which is our next nav point. RASO, you see that right here on our display. I think these are called PFDs, primary, or MFDs, main function displays, and this is the PFD, primary function display. I think that's the terminology. Either or, I'm not sure, PFD or MFD, PFD or MFD for this. But I think these are MFDs, and this is PFD. But I could be wrong. Sometimes I'm wrong. You see this, the center of this cloud here. It's got a little bit of more intensity than we were thinking, I was thinking, but worst case scenario is it gets a little bumpy the further to the east we proceed. And we're proceeding roughly at a track, a heading of 120, which is east by southeast, technically southeast. East by southeast. That's correct. All right. Yeah, these cells are below us. Should be getting handed off to a new controller once we cross this line here. It's going to change mirror space. Probably about 10 minutes from now, you should be getting a call from ground telling us to switch over to a different frequency and make contact with the new ground operator. Looks like we'll be flying into that here in about 10 to 20 minutes from now, so we're currently at roughly 45 minutes into today's flight. We are over land. Pretty inland down there. Roughly 28 minutes remaining in this leg. Setting our heading bug for 240. Our landing and approach heading is 060 degrees, and if we add 180 to 60, we get 240. The reason why I'm doing setting in a heading that is 180 off from our approach is in case we missed a runway, and we can just select that and it will turn us around, and then we'll just make two turns at 90 degrees each, and there we are. Looks like the cloud cover is picking up a little bit at our altitude here. Nothing too crazy yet, but a little bit more than I was anticipating. Looks like we're going to be in the soup here in about 5 more minutes, so on the other side. Looks like we'll be skimming the tops of these clouds for not sure how long. 21 minutes remaining in this leg of the flight. We've been airborne roughly 45 minutes. Total time today so far is roughly 54 minutes. If everything goes well, we should be on the ground at about 1 hour, 20 minutes, 1 hour and a half, somewhere in that ballpark. So I think we'll have broken clouds throughout most of this. Nothing too crazy. And our headwinds died down a little bit. Down 8 knots from 12. So some people might be curious, why does it show the wind blowing at our nose here, but this is at a different angle? Well, if you look at the map, we're flying along this line via GPS, and the wind is blowing this way, which is what we're seeing here. So it's just our orientation on this map is different from our actual orientation. But the heading is still the same. We're still flying at 125. So they're showing us the same thing, even though it looks different. We can see clouds starting to pick up on the map here, and the worst looks like it's behind us, so. And nothing really too notable on radar. Okay. Let's go back to GPS view here and go back to radar if things look like they might be getting nasty again. Weather data.
That's our FZAA is our designator.
Still too far away from that. Nothing available there. Nothing available there. Could be possible that no data is available, so we won't worry about it. We should get updates when we get close to our initial approach point. Too bad of a day. Minutes remains in this leg. I will step away for just a minute and I'll be right back. All right. 9 minutes left in this leg flight. Looks like the weather's actually kind of starting to worsen from what I thought it was going to be on today's flight, so yay, bad weather. Winds are still really light, so we'll hope that holds out when we land. Minutes remain to our next nav point, race hop. is the last long leg on our flight plan today. So we got 45 minutes until we hit Belgu here, and then we'll begin for initial approach into the area. We'll probably be around 10,000 feet by the time we reach Belgu. 10,000 to 6,000 feet. And we'll be directed in almost a straight in approach to the runway 06.
All right. Smooth sailing. Headwind's still the same, 6 knots, but nothing too bad up ahead. Still looks overcast, partially cloudy, but nothing too scary, so let's hope it holds out. Thirty-five minutes remain on this leg of the flight. I think we should be able to see the ocean off the right wing if it wasn't so overcast. Kinshasa here is 17 million people. Pretty big city. Back in a few minutes, dogs outside are barking. Looks like it's starting to clear up down there. Clouds are breaking up.
All right. Need the coffee refilled.
Looks like headwind has changed to a crosswind, so we're bouncing around a little bit more than we were before I got coffee. Roughly 18 minutes, and then we should be preparing for our initial approach here by the time we hit Belgu, or shortly thereafter. You can see that on the GPS map right here. Belgu! Bravo Echo Lima Golf Uniform or Umbrella. I like uniform, it's easier to say than umbrella. Until our next nav point. So far, 1 hour and 50 minutes into today's flight. We should be on the ground in roughly 40 minutes from now. Computer says 30, but I think it'd be closer to 40. Down we go.
be there in about 6 minutes. We are 2 hours into today's flight. Roughly 15, 20 minutes before we're on the ground. We have 5 minutes before we reach Bellevue. We will then make a left turn onto an approach heading of 060 degrees. Once we make that left-hand turn, that marked the beginning of our initial approach into the area. If you could, please pick up all your trash, chug your beers, anything left, and get everything all stowed up. We'll be on the ground here pretty soon. Roughly 2,000 feet, 2.5 minutes remaining in the descent. Belgu and our big left turn. Barometer has been reset to actual pressure in the local area. Approaching flat level 130, 13,000.
This marks the beginning of our initial approach into the area. If you could, pick up all your stuff, stow it in the trash can, and we should be on the ground here in about 15 minutes. Enjoy what remains in the rest of today's flight. Looks really pretty down there on the ground. Say we turn landing lights on. Spotted. I think it's right here. Straight ahead. Right off the nose. Headwinds died down. That's nice. approaching flight level 5,000. Down first level, first notch. I'm not going to wait for ground instructions. We're going to overfly the airport if that happens, so I'm just going to descend down to 2,000 feet. They will not like that. That's okay.
Dover 019er, you are 300 feet below your assigned altitude. Climb and maintain 5,000 feet altimeter, 29.78.
Climb and maintain 5,000 feet, Daher 019er. Kinshasa Center, Daher 019er, would like to cancel IFR.
Daher 019er IFR flight plan is canceled, radar service terminated. Squawk 7000. Maintain VFR. Frequency change approved. Good day.
Kinshasa Center Daher Foxtrot Mike 1019er is type Daher TBM 915 miles northeast of Foxtrot Zulu Alpha Delta 4,200 feet. Request flight following.
Daher Foxtrot Mike 1019er Kinshasa Center. Squawk 0007.
Squawk 0007, Daher 019er.
Daher 019er radar contact 16 miles northeast of Foxtrot Zulu Alpha Delta 3,800 feet. Altimeter 29.78.
Roger. Hello? Daher 019er.
Do not have the runway spotted yet. Down there. Look at those rolling hills. Looks like Kentucky.
Daher 019er contact Brazzaville approach on 121.1. Good day.
Landing keeper.
Going to 121.1 Daher 019er. Brazzaville approach Daher Foxtrot Mike 1019er 2,300 feet.
Dollar Foxtrot Mike 101, Niner Brazzaville approach altimeter 29.78. Continue to Amoeba as planned. Dollar 01, Niner contact. Kinshasa approach on 119.7. Good day.
119.7 Daher 019er. Kinshasa approach Daher Foxtrot Mike 1019er 2100 feet.
Daher Foxtrot Mike 1019er Kinshasa approach altimeter 29.78. Continue to Amoeba as planned.
Still do not have eyes on the runway yet. Regardless of where the runway is, this is a beautiful valley we're going through, so... on the runway. Should be about 15 miles out. Okay, this time for reals. I think that's the airport right off the nose, straight ahead. Okay. fully configured for landing, gear and flaps, full out. Flight is stable. Really liking this valley, this is beautiful. To go around.
Dover 019, did you copy?
Yes.
0019er, you are not clear to land. Clear the runway.
Probably not gonna let us park.
Kinshasa Ground Daher, Foxtrot, Mike 1019er request taxi to parking.
Daher Foxtrot, Mike 1019er taxi to general aviation parking via taxiway Alpha.
Taxiing to general aviation parking using taxiway Alpha Daher 019er.
Seriously? You can have us parked there and you got all these cars and stuff in the way? Alright. Well, we are down and I'm going to call it a flight right here. I hope you've enjoyed it and y'all have a great day.